Welcome, St. John's. We're so glad to have you here this morning. A couple announcements, just a couple reminders that you'll find in the bulletin. Today are Christmas carolers wanted next Sunday at 1 o'clock. We're going to go to the nursing home in assisted living and sing outside, and we would love to have you participate with that. So get with me or the church office if that works into your schedule next Sunday afternoon. And also, there is more decoration to be done. So if your family is interested in helping us here at the church, getting things finished up as far as decoration, call Kim at the office and you can arrange a time that works for you. With that, please rise for confession and forgiveness. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. 1 John 3 tells us that if we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive us of our sins and cleanse us of all unrighteousness. Let us confess our sins in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake forgives us all of our sins. As a called minister of the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. You may be seated.
Come to us, O Lord of glory, and shine in our hearts.
Let us pray. Stir up your power, Lord Christ, and come. By your merciful protection, save us from the threatening dangers of our sin and enlighten our walk in the way of your salvation. For you live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Lord, we thank you and we praise you for your gift to us divine. As we celebrate this Advent, fill our hearts with hope sublime. Candles glowing, spirits growing, as the Christ child comes to earth. We rejoice his holy birth. We rejoice his holy birth.
The first reading is from the book of Isaiah, chapter 64. Oh, that you would tear open the heavens and come down, so that the mountains would quake at your presence, as when the fire kindles brushwood and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to your adversaries, so that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome deeds that we did not expect, you came down. The mountains quaked at your presence. From ages past, no one has heard, no ear has perceived, no eye has seen any God beside you, who works for those who wait for him. You meet those who gladly do right, those who remember you in your ways. But you were angry, and we sinned. Because you hid yourselves, we transgressed. We have all become like one who is unclean, and all our righteous deeds are like a filthy cloth. We all fade like a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away. There is no one who calls on your name or attempts to take hold of you, for you have hidden your face from us and have delivered us into the hand of our iniquity. Yet, O Lord, you are our Father. We are the clay, and you are our potter. We are all the work of your hand. Do not be exceedingly angry, O Lord, and do not remember iniquity forever. Now consider, we are all your people. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please join in a responsive prayer of Psalm 80. Give ear, O shepherd of Israel, you who lead Joseph like a flock, you who are enthroned upon the cherubim, shine forth.
Before Ephraim and Benjamin and Manasseh, stir up your might and come to save us.
Restore us, O God, let your face shine that we may be saved.
O Lord God of hosts, how long will you be angry with your people's prayers?
You have fed them with the bread of tears and given them tears to drink in full measure.
You make us the scorn of our neighbors. Our enemies laugh among themselves.
Restore us, O God of hosts, let your face shine that we may be saved.
But let your hand be upon the one at your right hand, the one whom you made strong for yourself.
Then we will never turn back from you. Give us life, and we will call on your name.
Restore us, O Lord God of hosts. Let your face shine that we may be saved. Amen.
The second reading is from the book of Corinthians, first, chapter 1. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. I give thanks to my God always for you because of the grace of God that has been given you in Christ Jesus. For in every way you have been enriched in him, in speech and in knowledge of every kind, just as the testimony of Christ has been strengthened among you, so that you are not lacking in any spiritual gift as you wait for the revealing of our Lord Jesus Christ. He will also strengthen you to the end, so that you may be blameless on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. God is faithful. By him you were called into the fellowship of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The word of the Lord.
Is for the reading of the Holy Gospel. My apologies. The Holy Gospel according to St. Mark, the 13th chapter. Glory to you, O Lord. Jesus said, "In those days after that suffering, the sun will be darkened, and the moon will not give its light, and the stars will be falling from heaven, and the powers in the heaven will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in clouds with great power and glory. Then he will send out the angels and gather his elect from the four winds, from the ends of the earth to the ends of heaven. From the fig tree, learn its lesson. As soon as its branch becomes tender and puts forth its leaves, you know that summer is near. So also, when you see these things taking place, you know that he is near, at the very gates. Truly, I tell you, this generation will not pass away until all these things have taken place. Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will not pass away. But about that day or hour, no one knows, neither the angels in heaven nor the Son, but only the Father. Beware, keep alert, for you do not know when the time will come. It is like a man going on a journey when he leaves home and puts his slaves in charge, each with his work, and commands the doorkeeper to be on the watch. Therefore, keep awake, for you do not know when the master of the house will come, in the evening, or at midnight, or at cockcrow, or at dawn, or else he may find you asleep when he comes suddenly. And what I say to you, I say to all, keep awake." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Kids, I invite you all to be seated. Grown-ups, you can be seated too. In just a moment, kids, I'm going to have you come forward at the end of the children's sermon to get the packet. And I'd invite little kids and big kids to come up to get a packet. I think we might have to rely on the reserve packets, which are out in, Mr. Isebrand, they're out in the narthex in the entryway. Could you grab the basket of binoculars? All right, so you can see that I've got this nice pair of binoculars here, right? And can you see the binoculars? They're kind of tiny. But what do we use binoculars for? We use binoculars for seeing things that are far away so that we can watch. And see, I see my daughter is sleeping in the back there. Caitlin, I'm sorry, sweetheart. I shouldn't make light of you that way. But thank you, right? So we use binoculars for watching for people, don't we? Or for watching for things. Well, the season of Advent, right, is a time where we watch for Jesus. We don't know when he's coming back, but he promised that he would come back so that he would take us all to heaven. Okay? So we know that Jesus is coming back, and we know that Advent is a time to watch for Jesus. So I've got this great packet to hand out. Okay. Thank you, Mr. Isebrand. So, kids, at the end of the children's sermon, I'm going to have you come up and get a pair of binoculars. Now, you'll need your parents' help to make these binoculars, but never fear, there's instructions, okay? So, it's really easy. And I've even got some slides to kind of show you how this goes here. Okay. Let's see if the clicker works. Yep. Okay, so your piece of paper is white, all right, but these ones up here are blue. So there's the directions. I'm not going to go through all of those, but there is a new picture for your binoculars for every single week. They're going to be really cool. Now, see, there's the 4 weeks of Advent, and we're going to start down here with Advent number one, okay? So we're going to be watching for Jesus, all right? Now, every week, can you see the dashed lines, okay? Every week, you will cut apart one picture, one set of pictures, okay? But you got to follow directions. Do not cut apart the two circles. Because when you make your binoculars, okay, you'll tape your binoculars together or glue them together, all right? And then you will take the Advent 1 and you can tape it to the end of your binoculars, okay? I tested this out. It actually works. What happens is, so here's Advent 1, okay, there's your two circles, and when you put your eyes up to the binoculars, this is what's going to happen. You're going to see one picture, all right? So this is the story of the angel, and the angel comes to the shepherds and announces the good news that Jesus is going to be born, okay? So, kids, that's what we're going to do. There's a new picture for every week of Advent, and every week the children's sermon will be using our binoculars. So once you've got your pair of binoculars, hold on to them, okay? Keep them and keep your packet, okay? And then once you've looked at that, then there's also the Christmas story that goes along with each picture, okay? So at this time, kids, I invite you, please, keep your masks on, all right? Put on your mask if it's not, all right? Come on up, grab a packet, okay? These are open, so older kids can have one too. They're binoculars after all, right? They're pretty good stuff, okay? You guys want to, should we just pass these out this way, huh? Do you want to take a, yeah, all right. Go ahead and take two. All right, who else? All right, ladies, yes? Better grab two. Grab one for your sister, all right? So every week, we're going to do it this way. Okay, anyone else back here? Of course. There we go, Jaeger. Go ahead and take the whole packet, buddy. Plastic bag, too. Excellent. Okay, Ian? All right, kids grow up all the time, don't they, huh? Do you want to take one of those? All right, that'll be lots of fun. Okay, Megan, Sophie? There's one there. No? All right. There you go, Jonathan. Ethan. Make sure you get one for your brother, okay? All right, well, very good. So Advent is a time of watching and a time of waiting. You're welcome. I was really excited to make these. Okay. So Advent is a time of watching and waiting, and so we watch for the Lord Jesus, and we wait for His return. And so I say to you, dear friends, peace be with you from our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. I just got back from deer hunting. You may know I went away for Thanksgiving. And so today I'm going to tell you a couple of stories from deer camp about watching and waiting. Because actually, they mirror very nicely both the gospel lesson from Mark, where Jesus tells us to keep alert and be on guard, and also the lesson from 1 Corinthians. So, let me explain what I mean. There are two things that are necessary for us to be prepared for Jesus' return. And by the way, when we speak about the Lord's coming again, we speak of it as an actual coming. It's not figurative, it's not imaginative, it's not a parable, it's not an analogy. We do wait for the Lord Jesus to come again. And no one knows when that time will be. But He says, watch, wait, be alert, and keep on the lookout. He also tells us that we have been well prepared for such watching and waiting. St. Paul says to us in 1 Corinthians there that all of God's grace has been given to you and you have been enriched in every way. So you are lacking nothing that you will need to be prepared to watch and wait for Jesus. But you may need to be reminded, because we all do, to be patient. It's really not easy. What do we pray? Oh Lord, give me patience and give it to me now, please. Right? Well, let me tell you a little bit about deer hunting, because actually I think in some ways it is helpful when we think about watching and waiting for Jesus. So this last week I was out in the woods in northwest Wisconsin, and I had a couple of deer stands. The first thing that you need to know about deer hunting is that you're not going to be successful deer hunting if you're not actually in the woods, okay? You have to be in the woods, all right? You have to go out. And for whatever amount of preparation and gadgets and gizmos and whiz-bangs and all the stuff that hunters like, right? How many things do bow hunters have, right? There's a gadget for everything, okay? You could have gadgets A to Z and floor to ceiling, okay? But you're not going to be successful in hunting if you're not actually out in the woods. And it took me a little while to learn that. And so I would think to myself, I need this, 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 and this. I need to do that, X, Y, and Z also. And I would be so distracted and anxious about the preparations for going out to deer hunt that I would not actually enjoy it at all. Woody Allen once said that 80% of life is just showing up. Think about that. That's a B grade in school. 80% of life, B minus, I suppose, C plus. 80% of life is just showing up, is just being present. And so what you have to do is go out into the woods. And as we wait for Jesus, we be present. We show up. That's 80% of the grade right there, if I can use that type of analogy. Okay? But St. Paul says, you don't need to worry about what you're going to do when Jesus arrives, because you have been well prepared. Why are you well prepared? You're well prepared because God has given you His grace. You have heard His word. You've received Holy Communion. You've been washed in the water of baptism. Because you pray, because you cry out to God, you are well prepared. So just show up. Just show up. 80% of life. 80% of our Christian faith, too. But the other thing that you have to do once you're in the woods and sitting down is you have to be attentive. You have to be watchful. And deer hunting, it's hard to be watchful and attentive because lots of times it is utterly boring. I've got this one deer stand that I sit at. By the way, to help you with the nomenclature, that's what you do when you hunt deer. You go out to the deer stand and then you sit down on a chair. Why does that make sense? I have no idea, huh? But that's how it is. So I was at my deer stand sitting down, and in this particular deer stand, I've got one lane like this that I can look down, and I've got another lane over here that I can look down. And they're about as wide as the aisle there is. And so all day long, it's a matter of being present and being watchful and fighting off boredom. So I look down this lane, and I turn, and I look down this lane. That, too, is a lot like the Christian life. It's not always angels and bells and carols and... Right? I mean, you know that. There's some days where it's, But we persist. We persevere. We watch. We pray together. We support one another. We walk arm in arm, elbow to elbow, something like that. We help one another in those long moments of boredom where we must continue to wait and watch. So I'm sitting there in my deer stand, looking down this lane and looking down that lane. That's how it typically goes. But this year, it was nothing like that. It was all excitement. It was like Christmas Eve and silent night and candles and hymns and bells. It was magnificent. I sat down in my deer stand, and I no sooner had unpacked my gear, the little bit that I'd brought. I set out my thermos of coffee. I'd set down the rifle in a safe spot. And I looked down this lane here, and I thought, you know, I should probably pick up the rifle. It's an old rifle. I haven't used it very much. I should probably just sight the rifle down the lane. And so I picked it up and I sighted it down the lane. I thought, yep, that's pretty good. I did it a second time. I said, that's enough. I put the rifle back in its spot, put it on safety, of course, and I went to pick up my cup of coffee. And I looked down the same lane that I'd just been looking down, and I blinked. And there was a deer, all of a sudden, just like that, right there. And then I blinked a second time, and there was a second deer there, just like that. And so I had a very successful hunting season, right? But every once in a while, that too is what the Christian faith is like. It's wonderful. That's what we're called to do, is watch and wait and persevere. We've been well prepared, but sometimes it's pretty boring, right? It's pretty tedious. But at the right time, in God's time, at that moment that only the Father knows, when we will blink and all of a sudden, here the Lord is. He comes. So we watch and we wait. Now, I will close this morning by saying just this. In the gospel lesson here, the Lord says that when he comes, you know, it could be at any hour, any time of day, and we'll be a little bit surprised. But though we may be surprised, we don't have to say to one another, did you know that Jesus has arrived? Did you know that the Messiah is here, that the Christ has come? We won't need to tell each other. You will know because you've been well prepared. And here's why you will know. In one of the other gospel readings, Jesus tells a parable about how as the lightning flashes across the sky, so it will be when the Son of Man comes. It's not a parable, it's a description. I misspoke there just now. Okay? You know how it is. When you're laying in bed at night and there's a thunderstorm outside, you're not looking out the window. Your eyes sometimes are even just closed. After all, you're trying to go to sleep. Right? But when the lightning flashes, even when your eyelids are closed, what do you see? You see that flashbulb go off, and you know that lightning has struck someplace. And then if you need any confirmation, there's the thunder a little bit later. Jesus says, this is how his return will be. It will be as though the lightning flashes across the sky, even if you're not looking directly at it at that moment. You will know that the Lord has come. So in this season of Advent, dear friends, we wait, we watch, we persist, we rejoice with one another, we help and encourage each other, because we know that the Lord will return, and when he does, he will make all things right. Peace be with you, and God's blessings to you in this season of Advent. Amen.
Please rise for the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray. Lord, Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for preparing the way for us, Lord, that while we wait, we know that we are yours. Lord, be with all those in the Church Universal, its ministry, and the mission to share the gospel. Lord, be with all those, our creation, and all those that you have created, Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, we ask for your peace and justice in the world, the nation, and those in authority and in this community. Lord, we also ask that you be with the poor, the oppressed, the sick, bereaved, and the lonely. Especially be with Tyler, Audrey, Dieter, Daryl, Denny, Diane, Denny, Glenda, Ron, and Naoma. Lord, bring your Holy Spirit near Stu, Dave, Tim, Jeff, Sharon, Braden, Wanda, Jane, and Edwina. Lord, bring comfort to Shirley, Robert, Denise, Joyce, Jim, Lily, Walker, Cade, Dylan, Moni, Ken, and Dave. Lord, be with the family of Wanda Delperding as they suffer her recent loss. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we ask all these things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you all.
And also with you.
Please share in God's peace. Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, maker of all things. Through your goodness, you have blessed us with these gifts, ourselves, our time, and our possessions. Use us and what we have gathered in feeding the world with your love through the one who gave himself for us, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Amen.
On the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat, this is my body, given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This is the new covenant of my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." Gathered into one, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Come all now is ready.
Savior comes at last. Burrows lie open for God's creative task. It's the labor of people who struggle to see how God's truth and justice set everybody free. People of Israel, you heard the prophet tell. A virgin mother will bear Emmanuel. She conceived him, God with us, our brothers whose birth restores hope and courage to children of this
Now may the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. In your mercy, strengthen us through this gift in faith towards you and in fervent love towards one another. For the sake of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. May he look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Good news to the poor, to bind up the brokenhearted, and make you known even more, so that people living in darkness will see the grace.
Go in peace. Serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you, Mike.